Hello, this is Jeremy from AltRider, and we're going to do the installation on the new aluminum center stand for the Tenere 700. This was a huge development for us to replace the OEM steel or aftermarket steel center stands. When thinking about a center stand, a couple of aspects you really want to be considering when you're looking at what's available on the market. First and foremost, weight, right? Anything that we're bolting onto these bikes, is it necessary? Is it strategically or is it structurally built correctly? The spring quality, man, that makes a huge difference. What a nightmare of having one of those center stands that aren't able to stay up and out of the way. That goes also back into the weight. And then the hardware quality, paying attention to the hardware quality. And then how did the installation go? This was an awesome project. We were able to shave over 40% of the weight from the OEM center stand. And heck, guys, the pricing is damn near the same as the OEM one. Let's jump in. I'm gonna first talk through what comes in the kit. Then we're gonna talk about the tools necessary. And I'm going to start on this older Tenere. We put the OEM skid plate back on, but then I'll close with putting the AltRider skid plate on. What you'll receive when you get your center stand is your 3-pound, amazingly lightweight aluminum center stand. You're going to get the brackets right and left, and then we'll have the bushings for the center stand, the thrust washer, 2 spacers that will go on the bracket, 2 M10 bolts, M10 shorter bolts, 5 M10 washers. Of course, that'll go with this third length M10 bolt. We've got 2 M10 lock nuts. These are the ones that are going to secure the center stand. I've got 2 longer M8 bolts. They're M8 washers. They're M8 lock nuts. This is the bumper stopper, the washer and the locking nut there. One final bushing, your heavy resilient plated spring, and we also include the spring puller. Guys, these are super valuable to have in your toolkit later. When ordering from AltRider, you'll receive a resealable bottle of Loctite. This is a great 2-milliliter bottle that you can then take with you in your toolkit after you've finished doing the installation. Now on the tools that we're gonna need. Ratcheting spanners, super helpful, not necessary, but for sure if you're gonna be going with the AltRider skid plate, the ratcheting 13 at the end makes the final installation very easy. M16 spanner, M15 spanner, and a 13 millimeter spanner. And then I've got my 16 millimeter socket, I've got a 15 millimeter socket, then dropping down to my 1/4-inch drive, 13 millimeter socket, my 12 millimeter socket, and then my 8 millimeter socket, and an M10 socket. We engage with the 2 M8 fasteners. So I'm gonna talk through this in case you've not purchased the AltRider design, but you've got another skid plate and you're concerned about the compatibility. It's fine if the skid plate utilizes these 2 M8 frame bolts. We do because we feel that the small tabs on the frame bar is not enough for a skid plate. So we are capturing both of these M8 bolts, and then this bracket's gonna capture that from behind, so that I'll show you in the video when we do the installation. That's why the ratcheting spanner is nice, because then you can do that final tightening of those nuts from behind. Okay, to get started, you'll need to take off your skid plate, grab my M8, and then we're gonna just drop the 4 OEM bolts and then drop our skid plate. You guys have the AltRider skid plate, remove that and we'll get started once the skid plate's done. If you're gonna be reinstalling your skid plate, save your hardware, of course. I always like to start with the rider's right-hand side. That's the one with the spring mount and the rubber bushing. The other reason why it's advantageous to do that is you're starting on the right-hand side before you have to do those frame bolts, the M8s. So let's get all our work done on the right-hand side before we have to do those 2 frame bolts. So I grab my right-hand side bracket. I'm gonna put my rubber bump stop in place. I've got my nylock. Go ahead and just snug that up. You don't need to over torque it because it's sitting embedded in rubber and you have a nylock on there. It's not gonna back off. So just snug that guy into place. And now we're gonna grab the 2 longer M10 bolts and I'm gonna grab my M10 washer. I'm gonna grab my Loctite. We're gonna jump over here with our 12 millimeter and remove these 2 OEM bolts and then we'll align this bracket. And you will not be reusing these bolts. Remember, we grabbed the 2 M10s with the washers. I went ahead and fed my 2 M10 bolts, the washers. These 2 bolts, this is our mount for the center stand. Always ideal to feed your bolt through the bracket or whatever you're doing, then put your Loctite on so you're not smearing your Loctite off as you pass it through the brackets. And then two or three dabs. Of course, the amount of Loctite you put on is correlated to the size of the bolt, right? So if I've got a lot of diameter, I'm going to need a lot more versus a smaller diameter. I don't need as much. And of course, the Loctite is only relevant at the fastening portion, right? So at the end of the bolt where it's going to be sitting in the nut or the threaded frame. Get these guys going. And then this is a 16 millimeter, again, for the AltRider bolts. I've gone ahead and put my 16 millimeter on an extension. Gets me out from the foot peg. And again, let's torque that to spec. Okay, let's jump to the other side. So now let's prepare our right side bracket. This is the bracket with the stop for when it's in full deployment. This tab is on the inside of the frame. These are for the center stand. Put these two washers with the center stand, the bushings for the center stand. This bolt is gonna come in the M10 from the backside there. Thrust washer goes with my center stand assembly. These two long ones are now what's gonna replace those M8 frame bolts. So these 8 millimeters, I'm getting them prepped. They will go through here, but after they go through the frame and the skid plate, which is what we're getting prepped, these are the two basers that are gonna hold the bracket out. And then my final nuts, we will have a frame and our skid plate in place. This spacer will reside, this will sit here as well, along with these spacers. It'll make a lot more sense when we jump down there. Okay, so I'm gonna take my 12 millimeter to take my OEM frame bolts off. I've spoken about this before, guys. Just be cognizant that this frame spar can be under load from the center stand. If you're struggling with it, you can lean the bike up against a wall and it can dramatically make the alignment of these the threaded aluminum spar here. And you wanna be really careful because this OEM spar is aluminum and it's what has the thread. So you wanna be careful you don't cross thread it, get that started. And by not having the load on the center stand, sometimes can be really helpful for that situation. So here we go, I'm gonna take these off. You can save your OEM bolts because you won't need them for installation. This is gonna thread in through the backside here. I've got my M10, my washer, my spacer, and then I'm gonna put my thread locker on so that I don't knock it all off. So this is the threaded boss we're going for. We'll then pick up these two frame bolts afterwards. So let's get this one started and then we'll get the rest going. So nice and easy, no load, no challenges. We're gonna just get this set into place. Now that we've got our bracket in place, if I'm not putting on the AltRider skid plate or the OEM one, it's time to put the two M8 bolts. Once we get them started, the spacer resides between the bracket. Because we're using the flange nylocks, we don't need Loctite on this application. If I was not doing the AltRider skid plate, I'd get that started. Now that's able to grab there. I'm gonna go all the way through, which will capture the bracket. And then we can put the nylock on. I'm just showing this again if you're just doing the OEM skid plate. Here at the M8, I'm gonna cinch the M8 bolt up against the aluminum, right? Remember that's threaded. Then I'm only gonna hold this bolt and then I'd run my nylock on and I would just and only turn the nylock. Again, without the skid plate on, it's really easy to do this installation. So with my 13 millimeter, torque the bolt to the frame, then hold the bolt static and do the final torque on the nylock. I went ahead and got the AltRider skid plate installed. I've got all my fasteners started, but you can see I still have some movement here. So I haven't cinched everything up. A great little tool tip is to, let's just get our shifter out of the way. And the easiest way to do that is to actually come up here and pull the linkage. Before I pull the linkage though, there's a hash that I believe is aligned with this OEM position so that your shifter ends up bagging the same. But there's also a peen, and you see that? So I'm gonna just put a little dot there that'll ensure that I get this back in the correct location. None of this is critical, because of course, guys, this is an easy adjustment if you find your shifter doesn't end up back in the exact spot you had it before. So let's go ahead and pull this. This is an M5, or number 5 Allen key. This bolt's gotta come all the way off because this spline, as you see there, that gets locked with the bolt. So you gotta take it all the way off, not just loosen it. And now with the linkage out of the way, we can actually rotate and get our shifter all the way up and out of the way. So I'm gonna start with my M8 bolt, my washer. I'm gonna get these guys started into that aluminum frame spar. So I'm being real careful to make sure I get my alignment, because remember, that's threaded aluminum. I want to make sure I got that right. I'm going to get the next one started, and then we can work on the spacers. Again, if this is getting loaded up or you have a lot of tension on here, lean the bike onto the wall and take the load off the center stand. So get these started just till that bolt's sticking through. I can feel that. Now we're going to grab our spacers and set them in between. There's our bracket still. We've had that M10 bolts holding it in the rear. Keep driving that home. And now it's going to hold that spacer. Let's do the next one. Go ahead and get the bolt started or sticking through the frame a little bit is a nice trick, especially for this rear one. And then now I can just get it to just pop right on there. I'm going to get this threaded the rest of the way through. It's going to hold those aluminum spacers, and then we'll slide the bracket on, and then we've got to put those nylocks in place. I'm just going to line this bracket in the rear. I'm just going to line that up, and they'll just pass through because they're going to get constrained with those flanged nylocks. And then remember, before we put the nylock on, we're going to actually torque this to the frame. Do the final torque now. So I'm going to grab my ratchet. I'm going to set the final torque, and then from here on out, I'm only going to hold the bolt, and I'm only going to turn the nut. So get my final torque, and this is the compression between the skid plate frame and the secondary frame spar. So torque this, and now let's grab our nylock. And here you go, you guys can see, you can feed in from the back. I'm gonna run that all the way down. So now I'm gonna feed my front. I just set that nylock onto the bolt. Here's our 13 millimeter ratcheting spanner. I'm gonna make this final part of the project so much more doable. You're gonna get your ratcheting going, and you might find it more advantageous to get the first one set, but you can see how that ratchet is so nice to be able to get in there and get that torque down. And we don't have to worry about hitting our exact torque spec because that's a nylock and that's just constraining the bracket on there. But I'm gonna go ahead and snug that down, that nylock, and now I'm done. So take your time, guys, and you'll find that nice and easy with that ratcheting wrench. We can now reset our shifter back into place. I'm gonna sight that line down the center from the spline shaft. Make sure that I end up, and so I'm off by one tooth. So I come back, there we go. Nice and in place. So it's not all the way in, it's flush, and you'll catch that groove with your bolt. Remember that lock and groove? And torque that back up to the spec. Again, remember this, guys, that was the M10 that we had set in the beginning, a ratcheting 15 millimeter, and let's capture that, and we're just gonna finish tightening that home, and then you wanna cinch that and snug that to spec all the way in place. Now we've got our brackets in place, our skid plate in place, we're onto the home run for setting our center stand. Now that we've got our brackets all in place, all we've got left to do is just to hang the center stand, and then we'll set the spring. So we're actually on the home stretch. Go ahead, it's a great time, guys. Lube up your bushings. Any multi-purpose grease, I'm using waterproof Bel-Rabe. Here's the thrust washer on with the bushing, thrust washer or spacer. I'm gonna start with it on my non-deployment stand side. The spacer allows me to shift the center stand 1 to 2 millimeters either side based upon how the swing arm linkage resides. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that. I'll point that out here in a second. But I've got my bushings placed in there. I now got my two M10s. I'm gonna go ahead and set my washers in place. And I've got my two nylocks. I'm gonna get started setting the center stand in. I'm on the rider's right-hand side, mainly just to give you guys a better picture. We've got these M10 bracket spots now on our brackets that are hung. So I've got my center stand in place with my thrust washer, spacer, grease. Pretty easy, guys. I get that side set. I'm gonna get this one hung in there. I can just let it rest. I'm gonna now jump over to the other side. As you can see, guys, on this side, you'll feed the bolt in the same as the other. So we're gonna be feeding that bolt in from the center of the bike. And it even helps, I go ahead and get that started in the bushing and into the center stand. And then I roll that whole assembly up.
See that? So I'm ready to go. And then push that through. And now I can put my locking nylocks in place.
Go ahead and double check that you've got the clearance from the swing arm linkage to the center stand. If I were to change the spacer, it would then bring the center stand that 2 millimeters over if I had a clearance issue. Let's go ahead and get our nylocks in place. Good news is they're nice nylocks. So I just push that back to get that started. 16 on the bolt, guys. 15 on the nut. So let's go ahead and get that cranked down. And go ahead and snug that up, because you'll bottom out onto the bushing and you've got a nylock in place. Let's do our other side. Just wrapping up here now, let's go ahead and get the nylock set on the rider's right-hand side. And remember, always with a bolt and nut, guys, I want to do the final torque on the nut side, right? That way I'm not fighting any friction. Go ahead and check your range of motion, guys. We're just looking to make sure that we've got clearance on all the locations. You're going to notice that you're going to have some friction in the beginning until the whole system beds in. After just a few weeks of using it, it's going to totally bed in. Go ahead and grab your center stand spring, feed it through this pocket, that pocket, bring it to the upright position. I grab the hook inward, and then I'm going to set this. And then when you can grab yourself a helping hand, they're going to just push that down and in. And then that lets you set that peg onto the groove there. And then you're in place. Go ahead and check your range of motion through the stroke there and make sure that you're all good. Thanks very much for your time following us on the installation of the aluminum center stand for the T7. Hope you got a chance to learn something. If you've got questions, please reach out to us at AltRider. Proud about the fact that we'll answer the phone with our customer service. You've got access to some real engineers and the designers who are real riders. Let us know if you have any questions, and thank you for your time.